met these women in Taycan from the very beginning, from the school to the university, the lack of attractiveness of this study. This is something that affects to the business sector. It's a business case.
The EU can do a lot, and my commissioner has been very active in launching a number of initiatives. You know, breaking stereotypes, coming up actually with role models so that we encourage more girls to take up these STEM studies, encourage digital entrepreneurship for women. I have plenty of initiatives that I could mention as coming from the commissioner. The important thing is that we need to work together, all of us. We need to involve industry. We need to have many men on the board with us in order indeed to have this quite clear understanding that it's important for all of us to break this digital divide.
It's all about education, and education of course needs to start at the very youngest of ages, and it's about educating everyone. It's about educating girls and boys and everyone around us to take a look at an equal opportunity for taking a look at the possibility of their future. And for me, it's about also educating about the skill sets that are needed and how that's related to anything someone might choose in the future. By doing so, we're opening up possibilities of the fact that people can go into fields that they may not have thought possible, but also that they can take a look at fields that have a connection, and every connection has a connection to technology.
Girls should be exposed to computer science as early as possible. I think this is the most important thing to help to bridge the gender gap in EU. Actually, we see that if girls are not interested in computer science until age 12, they are not interested in this field anymore. So it's very important to start coding as early as possible.
We need a diverse tech sector. We need to have a gender balanced tech sector. So I think the EU can definitely help putting, you know, the highlights on the local and the national initiatives that can be taken across Europe and to make it Europe-wide. For instance, I created a meetup which is called the Paris Women in Machine Learning and Data Science. So within 1 year we succeeded to get from zero to 1,700 members. And this is definitely something that you can set up all across Europe. Actually, there's other meetups similar to ours in Poland, in Italy, and I hope more in the future.
I think the EU's done quite a lot, and I think it's done quite a lot to kind of highlight the concerns and has lots of initiatives in place, given of course the competence that it actually has to do things in this area. Lots of things are actually dependent on member states or indeed individual companies. I think what we're looking for is equality of gender irrespective of sex. And therefore, you know, there are certain professions where you, for example, see far more women than men. Let's say primary school. Shame for young boys to only have girls as role models. They need men as role models. So I'd like to see some more thought about how you do benchmarking across the board and how you reward companies and organisations for getting it right.